Yep. We want to give you guys a shout out for listening to the podcast at the end here. So it's December. It's that type of wrap up season where you're looking at the best stuff that happened during the course of the year. And what Spotify does is they give us Wrapped, obviously, what you listen to, but it also gives us publishers Wrapped, which sort of breaks down some interesting metrics about people who listen to our stuff.
Yeah.
So in the case of the Waveform podcast, we've got some numbers and some shout outs to give.
Yeah, it's always fun to look at. It shows us all different countries and what listen time and charts and stuff like that. I think we talked about it last year on the podcast, and it's just, yeah, it's fun. As a big thank you to everyone out there listening. Now on the, also just remember, these are only Spotify numbers. This doesn't include Apple Podcasts. This doesn't include YouTube. We still appreciate all of you out there, but your platforms don't give us a fun little thing like this. Spotify has just nailed the Wrapped portion.
They should. I tweeted that. YouTube should make a Wrapped that just tells you like which channels videos you watch the most minutes of. They know. They've got to know what ads you watch the most, what channels you've watched the most, you've watched them, and like how many people how many people you're subscribed to that you didn't miss a video. Like highest percent of watched videos during the year.
And even for you as the creator, how many people of your audience have watched every single video that got put out in a year?
When I see my Spotify Wrapped and it says you're in the top 2% of listeners of Electric Guest, I want someone out there to be able to say, hey, look, according to my YouTube Wrapped, I'm in the top 2% of MKBHD viewers. Yeah. I didn't miss a video. That would be sick.
That'd
YouTube,
be really cool.
Rebrand, rewind.
What would you name it? Oh.
There it is. Take back the rewind name. This is your chance. Build this feature, okay?
YouTube Rewind. Like a shared story kind of thing.
You can't use Wrapped. Spotify has that.
Yeah.
So call it Rewind. There it is.
Interesting. And they can't make any arguments. So like it would be easy in Instagram and Twitter and stuff like that because you kind of have these easy shareable posts, but Spotify doesn't have any of that and they still manage to do this.
Yeah.
So YouTube can easily do this.
Yeah, everyone just screenshots it and it's like an Instagram story you tap through. We'll give these shout outs in a second.
I'm going to look up a quick trademark so we can just sell that to Google before we...
No, I think they got to call it YouTube Rewind and they just got to own it and take it back and tell us like what we watched this year.
I was trying to think of like a Christmassy name for it that would just totally rip off Wrapped. Like YouTube stocking stuffer.
No. They got to own it.
Rewind for sure.
You're welcome.
Let's look at a couple cool things here. We have a bunch of slides. Adam grabbed just like a couple of the best ones here.
I want to react to them from the top.
Okay. Also, wait. Let's talk about Wrapped real quick though. Was the UI design like horrible this year?
Hasn't it always been horrible?
It's never been great, but it felt like specifically bad this year. There were some things we couldn't even see. It would be like a chart that would cover over the numbers that we were
supposed
to see.
On our side though. That was for the creator side.
Okay, that's on our side. Yeah, but even the other side, like the bar graphs that said like what genres you were listening to with the letters like really crunched up and
cartoons.
It was bad.
It was cartoony.
It's not great.
Apparently the Waveform show made some new friends in some new places and we got our first stream in 50 new countries this year, including Nigeria, Kenya, Ghana, Nepal, and Zambia.
Oh, so have none of those listened before?
Oh, wait, no, sorry. In fine print, the UI is bad.
Okay, yeah.
The UI is really bad. These places loved you the most, Nigeria, Kenya, Ghana, Nepal, and Zambia.
Okay.
But yeah, 50 new countries.
That's crazy because we looked last year and surprisingly, this always blows my mind, a lot of people around the world listen to this podcast. So 50 new ones in 1 year.
It's pretty sick.
Sounds awesome.
This again goes back to YouTube, but when I look at YouTube analytics, you can really get super granular with like how many people from this country in this age on a mobile phone watched this one video, and there'll be like two people from this one country. It'll be like a very small country.
Yeah.
From a random island country will have watched this video on a phone. I can see like the resolution of their phone. Like Google Analytics tells me everything. Fascinating stuff.
Shout out. And we also, this is just a little fun one that might be a tad humble brag, but in technology, the first day in 2021 that we made the top of a chart was January 1st.
That's pretty sick.
Pretty sick,
that's
right?
That's pretty dope.
And my favorite part is at the bottom, it says, we have a feeling this won't be the last, and I really hope it wasn't the last because we had a lot of room to get there again.
Charted on the first day. Was there an episode live on that day? Probably not.
No, I don't think it was even live that day, so that means we were pretty good. Yeah.
You guys were killing it.
In its first week, listening peaked in India on Friday, which is days of release, so that's awesome. your fans listen to it mostly at night, probably because of when we release the podcast is probably at night in India.
The middle of night, yeah.
So shout out, I can say I'm not someone who listens to podcasts at night. I guess maybe my ride home if we're here late, but shout out India, y'all listening at night. That's dedication.
If you're listening to this or watching on YouTube, leave a comment when you consume this podcast.
When and where you are.
Morning? On commute? Do you put us in the pocket? Earbuds? During a run? Let us know.
Yeah.
How are you consuming Waveform? Let us know.
I do want to know. Actually, that would be cool if Spotify was a little better, like YouTube, being able to get deep into those. It probably has it, just it's not as cheery and poor UI to put it into this. And then after India, the US was next on Fridays. I'm a little confused by this slide, if I'm being honest.
The UI. Ultimately, it was played in 105 countries. Shout out to every single one of those countries for listening to Waveform. And we had some impressive growth numbers that it made a little bar graph out of. Plus 38% followers on Spotify, plus 11% in hours listened versus last year, and plus 6% in streams. Those are all great positives. I'm glad there's no negatives. If there were, Spotify didn't show us to them. Spotify didn't
show
us the negatives.
Spotify for not so making us feel bad.
Appreciate the pat on the back there. We were also in the charts in 8 countries for a total of 304 days.
Okay.
Big shout outs to the podcast. The podcast listeners are coming through on Spotify.
They're coming through different countries. That means we were on a chart for almost every day of the year.
Right.
That's awesome.
25,055 fans listen to you more than any other podcast
on
Spotify.
That's gotta be my favorite one.
That's my favorite stat, but here's the funny part about that. I don't use Spotify to listen to podcasts.
Okay.
So my most listened to podcasts were random ones that I accidentally clicked once.
No. You had one on there that I know you listened to on Spotify and that it was kind of a new thing we all learned this year, the Pod Quiz Weekly.
Oh, because we listened to it a lot during our road trip.
I hope you've listened to it since then.
But I think that made it my number one.
I'm pretty sure everyone in the studio had that on there wrapped because we all played it so much on the road trip and have played it again since.
Yeah. So that's how Spotify, but yeah, I have like three or four other podcasts on there that I like clicked once. But yeah, shout out to the 25,055 people. I'm giving all of you credit for listening to Waveform more than anything else.
I mean, that's kind of neat because our numbers are usually in the, like, we have around 200,000 audio downloads and then the YouTube channel is around 50,000 usually. So if you think about just on Spotify, 25,000 of that listen to us more than anyone else. That's not including Apple, not including YouTube.
A good amount.
That's crazy percentage. Appreciate you. I hope that means we got people into podcasting and I hope people are listening to other podcasts because of us. That will make me feel good. So if you don't, just tell me you did anyways. That'd be nice.
1,825 fans spent their birthdays listening to you.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
If you're listening to this episode on your birthday, happy birthday.
And happy birthday.
And 1,826 then.
And then 6,641 of you listened to most of our episodes. Not sure what that means.
That's a very vague.
Most could be over half. Mm-hmm. It could be almost everyone. But we put out an episode every week, so that's a lot of you guys who are hanging on to every word, according to Spotify. Lastly, we released 2,861 minutes of content across 43 episodes, which is quite a few.
Which also means they wrapped their rap a little earlier.
43 weeks?
Yeah,
because
we can literally gauge that.
That's the thing. I was just thinking this morning. If you really binge Christmas music right now, it won't show up on your Spotify Wrapped ever because it already came out this year and then it starts the next year's Wrapped in January, right?
Yeah.
So I feel like a lot of people would have Christmas music on their Wrapped, but it doesn't count December.
I had a sneaking suspicion because Red Taylor's version came out in the middle of November and it wasn't on my top 100 songs anywhere. And
I knew it was played a lot.
Yes. And I know there are a million other people who should have been in there, like listening to that, and it should have been on their Wrapped and it wasn't. So I had the suspicion. I'm glad we could verify it through our I just had to start a podcast to realize what Wrapped is doing. But yeah, 22,861 minutes of content.
So a lot.
What do you think we're getting to by the end? If that's 43 weeks,
I'll do the math.
Add another 60 minutes for what? Probably like 6 more weeks on time, or no.
Times 52. I'm just doing the math on the averages. We'll be at about 3,460 minutes total.
Nice.
It's a lot of minutes.
Yeah.
The craziest stat for me is when I look at how many watch hours of YouTube content there were on the channel in the year. Oh, so it'd be like how many hours of human life were spent watching the videos.
How many brains were rotted?
And no, it's always measured in like years. Wait, ooh, I'm gonna check it right now. Like I'm gonna check it right now. If you were to take a random guess,
how many years of listening happened in 2021?
How many years of human life were spent watching MKBHD videos in the last 365 days?
365 wouldn't include last year's PS5 video, which is just feels like a milestone. 15 years? Do you have a guess, Adam?
I'm gonna go with 22 years.
So the number I have to do the math real quick, divided by 24. It is...
that face, please zoom in on that face.
It is 2,051,091 years.
Wait, in the last 365 days?
Yep.
On our channel?
Yep. 49 million watch hours, which divided by 24... is 2,051,000.
Wait, can you do the watch days, hours?
Sorry, days. Oh. Divided by 365.
Dude, I was
we should
like,
cut out my awful math
the
there.
World. Yeah. Do not cut that out.
Divided by, oh, I need to, hold on.
Our viewers have not seen the sun. 365 days.
5,619 years.
Okay, it's sad that that seems so little now because I just thought it was 2 million.
5,000 years.
That's crazy. What, I guess 15, you guess 22.
22,000?
No, 22 day.
22 years?
22 yeah. years.
That's 5,600 years.
That's still wild.
Do you want to know how many the podcast is in years?
Yeah.
92.5 years just for the podcast in 2021.
First year as a video. That's, I mean, longer episodes.
That's a lifetime. Somebody's life, an yeah. entire human life. Okay,
we
I'm done.
We sacrificed a life for the podcast.
That's a little strong wording, but sure.
No problems with it.
I think we ended on that then. So hey, thanks for watching this clip. Feel free to leave us a like for wearing these incredibly uncomfortable sweaters.
Yeah, Marques has been itching the whole time, so definitely give him a like.
It's a lot. Also,
vote on your best. In the comments, best sweater.
Leave a like for mine and a dislike for that one.
Well, that means it won't count mine at all.
It's all
give
likes.
Me a comment.
It's all likes.
Yeah. Thanks for watching. Subscribe, like, comment, bell notification. Is that it?